As interventional pain physicians, we use nerve blocks to both diagnose and treat sources of pain. The source of pain may be from joints or from the nerves themselves. Oftentimes, nerve blocks are guided with some kind of image guidance, either ultrasound or an X-ray machine. During a nerve block, a needle is placed next to the nerve and an injection of numbing medication and sometimes steroid is undertaken. The response to that injection may tell us the source of the pain as well as possible treatments for that type of pain in the future. Usually when a patient has a nerve block, we have you keep track of your pain for the rest of that day. An understanding of how your pain responds to the nerve block may guide us in future treatment options. Depending on the specific type of nerve block, you may or may not have some temporary muscle weakness. This can be expected and would be discussed with you by your physician prior to the nerve block. If this is the case, we ask that you take care for the rest of that day and be careful while those muscles are weak. Muscle function should return to normal within 12 to 24 hours. As with all procedures, there are risks with nerve blocks. Usually these risks are confined to bleeding, infection, and nerve damage. Use of image guidance and strict aseptic technique can decrease the risk of infection, bleeding, and nerve damage. Your physician may discuss changes to your normal medications, such as blood thinners, prior to your nerve block.